Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. In 2013, Scott Mitchell went 8-0 with a 0.31 ERA, 88 strikeouts in the playoffs. He was dominant. Only gave up one earned run in three starts. He capped off the playoffs with a two-hit shutout in the state Class 4A championship game to give the South River Seahawks its first ever state championship. And this guy's been the man all in the spring for the Seahawks. He's the All Met Player of the Year by the Sun, by the Washington Post, and he is Varsity Sports Network Pitcher of the Year. And Scott, I mean, going into your final season, I mean, what's going through your mind? I mean, I'm sure expectations were very high.
Oh, yeah, expectations were very high. I was just, it was all about the preparation for me. I went to Parisi Speed School all during all winter and throughout the first part of the baseball season as well. And doing that just got my strength up and my conditioning and everything. And that, I think that's what helped me the most. And then our winter workouts, we went down to this place in Scardina. This is the owner of Scardina. He has some batting cages, and we went down to some other place that has a bunch of cages, and got to throw there, got a lot of work in. It was awesome.
Talk about the great chemistry of this team. I mean, up and down. I mean, like all seasons, you know, it's not, you know, you weren't over, you guys weren't dominant, but you guys were steady all year.
Yeah, no, I think it was the energy level that we had. Everyone wanted to play for each other, like Coach Dunn as well. He's one of them. And just everything, everyone had the same goal in mind. We all went towards it. I think that was one of the biggest things.
All right, well, just talk about the attitude of this team. You guys coming into the playoffs, you were the third seed in the 4A East region. How was the team feeling? You guys were feeling pretty confident?
Oh, yeah. No, we were pretty confident. We just wanted to see who we were playing next and just prepare for them, you know? Just get in practice as well as we could and then get out. Just try to prepare as well as we can and play our game. Because whenever we play our game, we usually came out on top.
Yeah, just talk about the pitching. I mean, you were great. Greg Sheridan was great. I mean, all year, I mean, you guys were just really dominant.
Yeah, the past couple years we've been working with our pitching coach, Coach Gubbins, with me, Craig, and Pierce. I have a lot, and I think this is the year it all came together and everything just was set in concrete, and basically we just mowed through everyone. Everything was set up perfectly, so I think I give a lot of credit to Coach John, Coach Gubbins, and all the other coaches as well, just for the preparation for us throughout all the practices and stuff.
As a pitcher, how did you get better from last? I mean, what ways do you think you got better?
I can throw a little bit harder now, number one. My conditioning went up, my strength went up. And I think my composure on the mound, I just learned that I can only control 60 feet, 6 inches, and I can't really do anything about everything else that happens out there, like maybe errors and stuff like that, a couple of dinky hits or whatnot, you know. Just the composure. I think that's it.
Right, and of course, this was the final season for Coach Ken Dunn. Oh, first off, we got to, because Coach is behind me. Got to give a shout out to Mr. Patterson, because he forgot him in the early interview, so go
Jeffrey
ahead.
Patterson, this one's for you, for Coach Dunn. He forgot to shout you out in the other interview, so that's for you.
All right, but just talk about this. Like I said, you were one of, talk about the four-year, your other four-year starting
season. Yeah, it was me and three others that we started all 4 years on varsity, and it was just, I don't know, we kind of played ball with each other before then as well, but I mean, just being on the same high school team together and just getting better every single day throughout the springtime was just, I don't know, I wouldn't have won it any other way.
Man, just talk about the electric atmosphere you guys were feeling when you got to Ripken Stadium a few weeks ago for that state championship
game. I think we were all just trying to put out our best, and then whenever someone did really good, we were trying to top that, and I think that's what it is. There's a fierce competitor in all of us. It just all came out, and we wanted that state way bad, way more than the other team did, I think.
All the accomplishments you've had this year, I mean, what, you know, what did this season means to you?
Oh, it means to me and a big pretty much everything. I'm going to look back on this when I'm way older, hopefully, and it's one of the best years of my whole entire life. Nothing could have went as good as this did. I went 8-0. I mean, my one state's Coach Dunn's last year, literally, just perfect season.
Right, and he's about to take his talents down to Virginia, to Radford University.
Oh, yeah.
Scott Mitchell, he's the best Scott athletic, I guess, best sports Scott Mitchell since the old Ravens quarterback back in 1999, going back old school there.
Yep. Oh,
but this Scott Mitchell, senior for the South River Seahawks, he went 8-0 with 0.31 ERA, 88 strikeouts. Dominant in the postseason, only gave up one earned run, capped it off with a two-hit shutout of Catonsville in the Class 4A state championship, and for that, he is our Varsity Sports Network Pitcher of the Year. Congratulations, Scott.
You got it. Thank you very much.
For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Tony.